A few days ago, I received an email from one of you inviting me to your home to analyze and comment on your zero gas home built with a Huawei all-in-one system. I have to be honest, the email also conveyed a slight sense of challenge because it mentioned the fact that objectively I have never talked about this system in depth. Given that I enjoy challenges and that I was in the area due to my tour of events around Italy, I accepted this challenge without hesitation and also pushed myself to try a higher video standard than usual. In this video, I want to tell you how it went because it was an experience that really opened my eyes. Today we finally discuss Huawei. Let's not waste any more time, make yourself comfortable and let's get started. In order to comment on a technology, you need to be familiar with all its pros and cons. I often get asked for insights on this technology. Is it really reliable? What makes it so special to demand? But on the other hand, why do so few people on YouTube talk about it? I've decided to address this during the journey to stuff. I immediately got to work to understand which are the technical characteristics of the product, so as not to catch me off guard. I'll summarize them briefly given that, as mentioned, there are no insights of this kind on YouTube. So before I tell you how it went, let's take a moment to understand what the technical details of the Huawei system are for the photovoltaic system. I realized that it is an extremely flexible system, which optimizers can be combined with. It's not always necessary to have optimizers to monitor the production of each individual panel and maximize production from a 5 to 30% in case of shading and thus increase safety. In fact, the system is extremely safe thanks to artificial intelligence, which predicts arc flashes and cuts the power in half a second to avoid worse damage and also includes a rapid shutdown in 30 seconds in case of risks for those working on the roof. The artificial intelligence also activates for intelligent energy management based on operational habits, consumption and production prediction, allowing an independence greater than 95%. This is what they claim. We will see if this is indeed the case. The system includes inverters, optimizers and also batteries. In detail, LFP batteries, 100% lithium iron phosphate, optimized to handle 100% of the energy. The system is extremely quick to install and expand. In fact, it is possible to expand the capacity even after several years without it damaging the charge and discharge balances of the batteries. Okay, the product certainly seems very promising. The conversation with the homeowner and his response also amazed me. And soon you will hear his words, but first, before listening to his experience, let's visit the customer and check the installation to see what has been installed. Here we are, standing in front of this fully electric home that has chosen to be renovated with this in mind, moving towards the electric. And electricity is going to be the focus of this video. But let's start from what are usually the powerhouses of a 100% electric home system, the heat pumps. Here we have a 16 kilowatt Panasonic serving the air conditioning and heating system, which, as we will see, will be fully controlled via fan coils, thus a medium temperature system. Meanwhile, over here, we have a small heat pump dedicated solely to the production of hot water. So, we'll leave these two heat pumps of ours, again, one dedicated to heating and cooling through a medium temperature fan coil system and one dedicated to the production of domestic hot water, alongside two thermal solar panels that obviously come in, assisting the production of domestic hot water. Let's go to the boiler room. We immediately see that we have not one, not two, but three storage tanks. Let's start with this one, the smallest, which is the simplest to manage. An inertial tank placed as a hydraulic compensator feeds three booster groups on semi-basement floor, ground floor and first floor, which, as mentioned, are managed by a heating and air conditioning system via fan coils. We then move on to Aichin's double storage for the production of domestic hot water. We have a preliminary accumulation, which, as you can see here, is equipped with its own control unit for the production of hot water via thermal solar panels. The hot water, after being preheated by the solar accumulation made up of two solar collectors, moves to the actual sanitary production accumulation. So here we have the refrigerant gas pipes that come from the external unit, the one that resembles an air conditioner, the one from Aichin above, the pipes from the external unit via a coil exchange with the water and heat it. However, a fully electric home needs to produce its own electricity. And this is why we are now going to see what is the beating heart of an electric house, namely the photovoltaic system. If we've seen that the heat pump is the muscle of a completely electric house, well, here we have what is the heart of a completely electric house, that is the photovoltaic system, a system of over 17 kilowatts, a multi-layer system. This has led the owner, understandably, to rely on Huawei, thanks to the installation flexibility provided by the presence of Huawei optimizers, which, remember, may or may not be there. Here we have part of the photovoltaic system, which was installed and built on a double pergola. I return again to the choice of the Huawei optimizer in combination with the panel precisely measured to the actual pitches of the house. Here we only have 16 panels. The others you will see with the drone footage cover various slopes of the house. As you can see, we find different shadings. So the 17 kilowatt system is essential, and of course it covers all of the needs of the house behind me. It powers the heat pumps that are back there, and of course it must partly store the energy through Huawei's own storage systems, Huawei Luna storage systems, which, as we will see shortly, are crucial. Because the production of the photovoltaic system doesn't always manage to synchronize with the home's consumption, we have seen the heart, we've seen the muscles, and now let's go and see the brain of this completely electric home, the Huawei brain, which is responsible for intelligently managing all energy flows to maximize the production of the photovoltaic system as much as possible to avoid wasting energy and ensure maximum savings for this family. And here we are. It's quite spectacular to see a thermal power station done right, looking charming with plaster. It might seem obvious, but it's not. We of course have our three-phase inverter and our dual storage system. I can tell you I install many of these and it's incredibly compact. Unlike other competitors, I noticed that we have 5, 10, 15 kilowatt hours in a very limited size. So, it's certainly simple, and I think the installation itself is praiseworthy. Congratulations on the condition of the technical room, because sometimes the technical room is a basement, and it's much easier to install because the blocks are individual and can be aesthetically pleasing. It is particularly attractive, and one of the things that caught my eye, there are the two storage systems of 15 kilowatts each. They are a delight to look at. I was keen to design a room that does it justice. After all, the two inverters and two storage systems of 15 kilowatts each also have a display which virtually no one installs anymore. This allows for an immediate direct visual impact. It instantly conveys whether it is charging, if it's off, or if it's operating or not, even for an outsider. This is the master control panel, and the secondary is connected via KVUTP via LAN. There's a switch that enables internet or home Wi-Fi monitoring so that the system can be monitored, managed and configured. Beneath the inverter we find a unique box. What is it? It's a backup box that supports me in case of an outage, or if there's a lack of external power, it ensures that I'm never left isolated. I won't be left in the dark and will still have my guaranteed source of electricity. We've seen the inverter, we've seen the backup, we've seen the batteries, we've seen the optimizers and the panels. We're just missing one more thing. Let's go to see the column. So, under this shelter we have our column. I even made a rhyme with it. The column for electric car charging can range from 3 to 22 kilowatts. It self-regulates dynamically so as not to surpass the absorption of current from the grid. The task of having a single brain lies with Huawei's brain, which is to manage energy in an intelligent way. If the house needs to take on a bit less charge, and if I have surplus energy from the photovoltaics, I discharge into the battery or discharge into the car battery to try to limit the grid transmission as much as possible. He invited me from Turin to come here to show me your system, and first of all, obviously, congratulations, because in any case, the work was done in an excellent manner. And I certainly see the potential of Huawei, where usually I too on the channel have not brought up many topics in that sense, but question, why did you choose Huawei in your home?
First of all, for the aesthetic aspect, and because it is particularly attractive as a whole. And then because it is an only one system, so it is a mono brand, and I have a unique interface in case of any type of problem. This also makes it particularly simple to use in management and monitoring, precisely because being a single brand system, it is organized in an optimal manner. One thinks, and there is the column, and the batteries, and the inverter, and who does what? What do I have to do? Actually, show me that the application goes about its business, and in quotation marks, in an almost passive manner, in the sense that the house goes on because the brain thinks for us. How do you feel about monitoring? Very good, because I use a special app that is particularly simple to use and allows me to monitor and carry out any type of check on any point of the system.
So this is obviously the first application on the homepage. We have the instantaneous energy flows. Let's see how the system is doing now. It's going to be cloudy, 500 watts. The network withdrawal is practically zero. And then we have the battery. The battery is at 71%. The house consumption is 5.7 kilowatts because we have the heat pump. And all the various appliances, and above all, the charging station. Not the one you see back there, but the one for the other car. Below, we have all the statistics. This is essential to actually monitor and have control of what is the energy produced and what is self-consumed during the day, in the month and in the year. If we go and see October, it's not an extremely bright month where consumption begins to be important. Let's see. Self-consumption is 50%, therefore I only use the photovoltaic system at 50%. But that 50% exploited by the photovoltaic system generates me an independence of 98.62%. I'm practically self-sufficient. If I go back to September, we're at 99.14%, 99.10% in August, 99.37% in July. Then, having the Huawei and the optimizers, we can go and monitor the individual panels here below. So these here are the panels above our head, but you see how we have various layers where we find everyone else's panels. The fundamental point is precisely where the optimizers are, both for a monitoring reason for each individual panel, which allows us to check the design flexibility of each single panel, its production. Then moving to the third screen, we have all the devices. If I look here at the column, I see that one has a rated power of 22 kilowatts on the three voltages it is charging. Here too, we have a monitoring of the loaded energy, and obviously, as needed, we have all the necessary information. Going back, the battery overview gives me all the daily details. Going to the system details, I have all the information. In this screen, we can see, on a day like today, how the production of the photovoltaic system follows what is the classic bell curve. We also have here a slight intermittency resulting from the weather, but also from issues on the network and the house consumption. Let's see, after lunch, arrived home with a charging station with a consumption of 4 kilowatts per hour. I can monitor everything, including economically, and see the benefits. So a well-installed system generates a significant benefit. We are talking about around 11 euros per day. If also considering diesel saved, it's just a huge amount. We can see this even on days where I don't have optimal production, precisely because sometimes the weather doesn't help us. But the Huawei batteries, the high capacity of Huawei batteries, allow us to have maximum self-consumption. All this conveniently from your smartphone. You can check everything from your cell phone if you want. If you don't feel like it, just glance at, see the green LED, and you'll be calm.
We've already seen within the application that on an economic level, in terms of bills, a 100% electric house with photovoltaic batteries can satisfy all needs, all the energy you need, especially with the help of an electric car. Does it meet your needs or not? Absolutely, yes. 10 months a year, I don't exceed electricity production. The average for the remaining 2 months is still quite good. Absolutely, yes. Would you recommend this type of investment, this step forward, both on an electrical and a thermal side, that is heating with a heat pump and an investment with battery panels? Would you recommend it for those who still have some hesitations? Well, I would say yes. Absolutely, without any doubt. Just for the economic question, as well as the livability of the home, the benefits that are derived from it is a step that was also made for ethical reasons, to have an eco-sustainable house. And above all, after much independent research, I realized that the best choice was indeed to go with Huawei, because it is as I said before, a single brand system that guarantees me 24-hour assistance and above all the possibility to monitor and manage it optimally in the simplest way possible.
Did you hear his words? In the simplest way possible. This is Huawei's turning point compared to the competition. In summary, we have a system made up of inverters, optimizers, panels, and charging stations that ensure maximum safety. Thanks to arc flash protection systems, roof optimizers, and the possibility of an anti-blackout kit, the entire system is extremely safe. The batteries have a long life and are able to withstand adverse weather conditions. But the most important thing is the technical assistance service available 24 hours a day. I think it's the only one on the market that offers this level of service. The balance of all the components guarantees maximum efficiency, which translates into significant savings, thanks to the presence of optimizers that increase production by 5 to 30%, and flexible and 100% usable storage systems that communicate and load efficiently, thanks to artificial intelligence. They harness the energy produced by the panels to generate savings of up to more than 95%, as we have seen. So no, it wasn't just a slogan. Finally, both as a technician and an owner, the system is very simple to use and assemble. The optimizers allow flexible configuration of the strings, and as you have seen, owners can monitor and control everything via the Fusion Solar application for smartphones or via the display on the storage unit. I obviously thank the homeowners who, in addition to giving me the opportunity to talk about this system, opened my eyes to both the product and myself. I built a lot of castles in the air, and in the end I made a simple thing complex. It's their simplicity that makes it an excellent choice for those who want an efficient and easy to use photovoltaic system, for those who want to save on their electricity bill and also have a safe backup system. I understand that simplicity is often taken for granted, but it is a fundamental aspect that can make the difference. In fact, complexity can be a deterrent to the adoption of these technologies. If they are too complicated to install or use, people may be reluctant to install them, even if they are aware of their benefits. If the homeowner is happy, satisfied, and comfortable with the system, it means that the technology has done its job. Simplicity is therefore a fundamental aspect of these technologies. It is important that they are easy to install and use so that anyone can benefit from their advantages. Obviously, there is complexity, but sometimes for the homeowner, it could be a deterrent. Simplicity is what can make the difference. And you? What do you think of the system and my final reflection? Obviously, let me know in the comments and leave me some feedback on this first attempt to raise the standard of the videos to understand if it's worth it or not. I am really curious to read your comments, and if you are the owner or user of a Huawei system, let me know by leaving a nice star in the comments, so I can actually see if there are people who have the Huawei system at home or not, and we will see each other in the future with the next challenge. Hello.